Hello, viewers. This is going to be the first video of a multi-part series where I explain in detail how to create an entire website using the platform framework. Let's get started with a blank RapidWeaver project, as you can see. And first, put a stacks page in there. And we can see now that we have landed on the normal stacks folder. However, I have organized my platform stacks into a separate folder, which makes it much easier for me to actually work with this framework. Now, in order to get our project started, we should make sure that we have the platform theme selected, like here, it is already done. It carries over the last theme you actually used. So since I'm working with platform, my platform theme is always selected. Next up, we have to put the platform settings stack onto our page. The platform settings stack actually prepares the page for this framework. It loads the necessary CSS libraries. It contains core settings, which we are going to have a look at now. Let me just create some space for us by hiding the page list. And now we are opening the inspector for our platform settings. Here we have our breakpoints. If there's nothing special for your use case, you just should leave it the way it is. Then you have all the colors which the framework actually knows as the standard colors. You can modify them, of course, if you want. They are named. These names are being used in the CSS framework behind platform. So if the reference is on black, the black color is being used. However, you can make black a dark red if you wanted to. But if you do not have a very specific color scheme for your site in mind, you should also leave it the way it is. Now, these basic colors, these primary colors, as we call it, are used again in the derived colors. So these are also named colors, and there I can actually use these color names to make it easier for me to actually define these colors. For example, primary is the default. It's a kind of a turquoise, which you see here over at this tag. But if primary is in turquoise is not your thing, you can actually set it to orange or yellow or green. Then we get to the typography section. As I said before, you should actually leave it the way it is. Otherwise, you can also change, if you have a certain scheme in mind, change this to your specifications. This is followed by the text sizes. These are also named sizes, which are used in the CSS framework behind platform. Then we have the weights for the fonts. And in the miscellaneous settings, we have other things which did not fit anywhere above, like the radii and so on and so on. Then we get to a specific area, which is called effects. Here you can enable the page loader. It's a fairly simple page loader, and you can customize it by displaying a certain text, for example, this loading. Then we have certain styles where it actually fades in, or it comes in from the right or from the left. And then you can also give it a background color, which is currently on restricted to these colors, which are delivered by standard. Then we have stack-specific settings, which are global for the entire site, or page in this case, not site, page, where we can set the default colors for this particular steps stack. That much about the platform settings, which are mandatory to be put on every page you create with platform. Now, we want to actually create a nice web page. So let's get started with the first elements to put on this page. Let's continue by putting a hero stack onto our page. A hero is kind of a banner which can contain more headlines and introduce your page to the visitor. The hero stack brings a lot of possibilities with it, but in this case, let's keep it very simple and not modify anything. Maybe we do that later. We don't have to actually do much to make it look great, which is one of the great things about platform. Without many settings, basically with just dropping on the stacks onto your page, you already receive nice and very presentable results. Now, with the hero stack, let's give it an image backdrop. I've already prepared an image for us to use as the backdrop here. Let's put this into this image well. And there are just a few settings which we want to adjust. Currently, we have tiling and the image size isn't right and so on and so on. Let's just go and turn tiling off and change the image size to fill the hero stack. Already much better. Now it would be great if we could display some text on a background which makes it stand out a bit. So let's use one of the column stacks. Okay. We are going to use this column stack to give us a backdrop, a color backdrop. Yeah, this gray looks already quite good. And let's make it 50% transparent. This gives us a kind of a frosted glass effect. Now, if we look at this whole thing in preview, nothing much will be visible because actually we don't have any contents inside the column stack. Okay, now let's go back and drop in a two column stack. And on the first column, we are going to display an image. Let's just drop this picture in here. Close the resources. And I just dragged and dropped this picture into the drop zone of the first column. And if we click on it again, we can edit the image. And let's scale it down to 50%, otherwise it might be a little bit big. Click on Done. And in the second drop zone, we're gonna put a title as well as some content, which is text. The title we're gonna change to "This is platform," and for the text we're going to write something very quickly. Platform is the best way to create great websites. Okay, now that we have content, let's have a look what our preview mode is going to tell us. Yeah, okay, we have our frosted glass effect here, we have our image, and we have our text. What I don't like is that our image and our text is kind of glued to the top and the bottom of our one column stack. That's easy to remedy. Let's just go back to the one column stack and scroll down to our responsive padding section. Let's change the units of the padding to rem and give it a 2 and 2 rem on top as well as on the bottom. Let's have a quick look in preview what we did, and this is already quite presentable. The distance left and right looks good, which is provided automatically by the platform framework. We have added a nice spacing at the top and at the bottom. Now, what would be nice is if this headline as well as text would be here in the center, so that it lines up nicely with our image. Okay, let's go ahead and do that. Anything else we would like to do? Yeah, maybe change the color as well, maybe to a white. Okay, let's get cracking and do this quickly. Currently it's an H3 because it's the page title. Let's set this to 1. It's much bigger. We can do a similar thing with the content. We have 3 prefabricated sizes. So let's just choose middle size and confirm what we see here in the preview. That's already looks quite like a headline or a title rather than a headline. Okay. Later on, I'm going to show you how to actually integrate this text into the title stack, but for now, let's leave it this way. Okay, back to edit mode. We said we wanted to be vertically centered. In order to achieve that, we have a stack. There's a stack for that. That's the vertical stack. Let's drop in our title and the content. All right, now let's have a look at what the vertical stack can do for us by checking its settings. First of all, very important is that we can have a look at the breakpoint. So we can set the vertical alignment to show always, like on all screen sizes, or we can have it show on sizes larger than, including and larger than tablet, including and larger than desktop, or we can give it a custom breakpoint where we enter the figure manually here. Let's just set this to tablet and onwards and the position to center. Let's jump over to preview mode to see what's happening. Maybe not quite what we wanted, but it is centered. Now, actually, this title should be above the text. Why is it not like that? Because if you look at the vertical stack, everything which is in there is regarded as to be in this vertical center. So it puts the title to the left because it's in there first, and the content to the right because it's in there second. How can we get this to be above each other? This is why we have the nifty group stack, which doesn't do much, just grouping stacks. And let's drop in our title as well as our text and have a look. And voila, it's exactly as we wanted it. Back to edit mode and a quick look at the group stack. What do we have here? It is nothing else than a grouping of stacks, which makes it much easier to actually drag it around or copy it or even make a partial. We will talk about partials much later. However, the group stack also has a nice function. It makes the contents visible or invisible. So I can actually drop it down to almost nothingness if I don't want to see it. At the same time, it is not visible in preview mode as well, and it will not be published either, because it's just not visible. All right. But we want to see it, definitely. Now, with this done, we can actually say that we have properly laid out hero banner. Now we're saying we wanted to change the color of the text, so let's go back to the title. Change the title color to white, as well as the text color as well. Here we have the text color for the content stack. Let's set that to white as well. Preview this. And yes, cool stuff. Maybe quickly check what the content would look like if we made it large. Maybe not bad, but let's leave it on middle for now. Okay, now it's time to put some content onto our page. And we are starting by putting a one column stack on. And we'll work ourselves through all this. Let's also put some images into the three column stack. Don't worry, these three columns will be next to each other instead of on top of each other. This is now because we are on a laptop, the space is not enough, so the stack went into the mobile mode, but on desktop it will be side by side. And let me just go through these images and set them all to 50% size, just for space reasons. Okay. As you can see, since we do not have a picture here yet, we have a placeholder so that we can have something to work with. For now, let's have a sneak peek over at the preview mode. Here we are. All right, that already looks like something we can work with. Now, what I don't like is that our contents inside the one column stack is kind of very flush to the left-hand side as well as to the right-hand side. So let's sort this one out by going back to edit mode. Select our one column stack, like it is already done now, and go to the responsive padding section. Currently it's in the more easy mode. There would be also be an advanced mode by clicking on this plus sign. However, we do not need this. It is basically if you have special requirements for padding in the horizontal and vertical directions, as well as to have it active on different screen sizes. However, we do not need that right now because what we want to set will be always visible. So first of all, let's set the unit to rem and get the left padding to 2 as well as the right padding to 2 as well. Now let's have a look in preview what we have achieved up to now. So this looks already much better. Maybe some padding at the top would not go down too badly, like 2 rems. That looks already very nice. Now, since we want to be responsive. Let's check our simulator, what it's going to be looking like on a cell phone. So I go on to simulate, and already selected is iPhone 8, but it's vertical, now it's horizontal. And as you can see, there are still a few issues which we might want to address, like the spacing here in our header, left-right spacing. However, what we see below the header is already very nice. All right, let's go and tackle the header in the mobile way. Okay, so let's go back to edit mode and address the issue which we saw in the iPhone size simulation earlier with the header. So back to the edit mode, let's select the one column stack and add one RAM each on this one column stack. Over to the simulator, and immediately we see it looks very decent. All right. Next, let's have a look at the images. I'll just close the library very quickly to give us a little bit more space. And let me just mark one of these image stacks and scroll over to the general section which we have. First of all, you have the option to use warehoused images, which is very simple. If you mark this, you have a different entry option where you set URL links, but let's just stay with the default setting where you actually can browse either to your desktop, or you can also use resources, or you can use drag and drop. I've already prepared some placeholders for us, which will illustrate what I am going to show you now. So we have the option to have a specific image for mobile sizes. This is required, as you can see. Then we have the option to put in a desktop and a full HD image. Let me just quickly do that for the rest of the images. And the idea behind it is that, for example, for mobile devices, I have a smaller image than for desktop size screens, as well as for full HD size screens. And I'm going to try to simulate the behavior now. Let's go to the cell phone size, smartphone size. And as you can see, the browser selected the mobile image size for us. Now let's go over to something a little bit bigger, like a 13-inch MacBook. And as you can see, automatically desktop size was selected. Now let's choose something even bigger, like the 15-inch MacBook. And immediately the browser selected the full HD image size. So this way we can address image sizes in a responsive way. Now, with our images looking nice on all kinds of different devices, I think it would be nice to have some drama on our page. I would like to emphasize it by putting some animation on the images, and this is why we are going to use the animate on scroll stack. And let me just quickly prepare it for us. So animate on scroll means that once we reach a certain offset on our page, an animation will be displayed. So let's just set this to a 50 pixel offset. The animation will be fade down. Easing we can leave. The duration should be 300 milliseconds, and we will have a 200 milliseconds delay on this. If you only want to have the animation to be displayed once per page load, then you can select this checkbox. Now let's copy this twice, because we have three images. Let's pull this one down. Drop the image into it. Next one. Drop the image into it. And our last one. Now we want to cascade the effect. So first the leftmost picture shows up, then once this is finished, the next one in the middle will show up, and lastly, once that animation is finished, the right one is going to show up. So let's go and do that. See, I have messed up the delay. I wanted to have 200 milliseconds only here. So once we have 200 milliseconds plus 300 milliseconds, after 500 milliseconds, that one will show up. Last for 300 milliseconds. And this is 500 plus 300 makes 800. On this one, 800 milliseconds. And yeah, let's have a look what's going to happen. Very nice. Let's just scroll up, and as you can see, since we didn't use the trigger once option, the images disappeared again once we hit the top of the page. And now when we scroll down, the images are being displayed with our animation in sequence, just as we wanted it. Very nice effect for our visitors. The next things we have to address is, of course, our footer. We have nothing in there yet. So just let's put in some content. Seems to be the right stack for that. Web design with platform. Okay. This is the content. Let's center the stuff and give it a little bit of bigger size so that we can, large is too big. Let's put it onto medium size and now quickly have a look at our animation first and the footer. Let's just remove maybe the bottom margin of the content stack, which is still active, so I can actually still change that setting. Little bit better. I think we can, for our purposes, leave it like that for now. Let's give this a different color. We could also use a color gradient if we wanted that. Maybe a good idea in this case. Let's start with a darker gray and go over to a light gray. We can still change the angle of our gradient the way we like it. Maybe like this, give the content different text color, like white, so it stands out properly. And I think this is very nice for our page. Now, what still is missing is, of course, a menu. And for that, we use the power bar stack. Let's drop it on. And let's give us some space to see the desktop version of it. Overall, I actually think it is appropriate for our site style because we are using grays. So let's not change the color. And for the rest, I think it is also quite appropriately styled, except for maybe the sticky options. which would make the power bar or nav bar stick to the top of the page if we scroll beyond the top. Maybe a good effect to use. Let's mark it. We can select different menu types. For example, if we go for the automatic Rabbit Weaver menu, the menu structure will be automatically created for us based on our pages. Let me just rename this for the sake of this demo. Then we have the option to use a manual menu where we get an editor and we can create our own menu structure based on an unordered list. And the last option is, of course, the one known menu, which is called none, does exactly what it says. No menu is being displayed. Let's go back to the standard Rabbit Weaver menu. And if we head over to preview mode, you will see there will be one entry in the menu bar, which is called home. This is our homepage. But you will see once we fill this in the next episodes, there will be more entries popping up in our menu structure. As earlier said, we were using the sticky option of Power Bar. As you can see, it is checked. So once I scroll past the top, the menu bar will stay visible at all times. Maybe quite a good usability point here. So this concludes the first episode of the series Getting Started with Platform. Let me just quickly recap what we have learned and achieved in this episode. We have created a header for our website, which we will later on use as a header for the following and still to be added pages. We have learned how to do spacing based on the requirements of our pictures and so on, of our style guides. We dropped in images which can be responsive, and we gave them animations. We designed a footer, which still can be beautified if we wanted to do that. We had added the power bar navigation bar. We gave it a sticky option so that it is always visible when we scroll downwards. And this way we created basically the template for the rest of our website. If you need further information about the platform stacks, please head over to the documentation pages on the platform website. It is exhaustive and it explains all the options which you can use all in context. You have the opportunity to actually download little examples so that you can just use what's in the documentation straight away on your own websites. All right. If you could like this video and subscribe to my channel, that would be great. Hit the notification bell so that you are being notified once the next episodes are uploaded and available to view. Thank you very much for watching. Enjoy platform. Bye-bye.